Our top story, a man taken into custody by CHP officers ends up dead after yelling, "I can't breathe," 12 times. Good evening. Welcome to Fox 7 News at 5. I'm Alex Michelson.
And I'm Christine Devine. The video is explosive and disturbing, a warning some viewers may find it hard to watch.
I can't breathe!
This happened in Altadena 2 years ago before the infamous George Floyd video where he yells, "I can't breathe." This video was sealed until today.
Christina Gonzalez joins us live with the troubling video and what led up to it. Christina.
Yeah, it actually took a judge's order to get this video released, going against California State Attorney General, who's had it sealed pending the investigations. And I want to reiterate, it's difficult to watch. It's really difficult to listen to, but the family wants the public to see this. So let's show you what we got. The voice of Edward Bronstein on video shot by a CHP sergeant on March of 2020 inside the garage bay of Altadena's CHP station. Minutes before he had been placed on the mat after being arrested for DUI, which allows officers to take blood forcefully with a warrant if he refuses a breathalyzer or giving blood, which he seemingly had.
This is your last opportunity. Otherwise, you're going face down on the mat and we're going to keep on going.
The officers proceed to pin him to the mat, and you hear,
"I'll do it willingly, I'll do it willingly."
Before he starts to say, "I can't breathe," he starts to say, "I will willingly take the test now. I will willingly give the blood."
The man's family clutching his photo as attorneys narrate the video.
He says, "I can't breathe," 12 times is what I counted.
2 minutes after they start applying body weight to his back is when he stops breathing.
Are you gonna see it?
No audible response from Bronstein.
2.5 minutes into the altercation is when they start testing his blood. You can see them start taking a pulse, and there's no pulse.
Edward.
Wake him up.
It's not till another minute passes, while they're still drawing blood, that you hear officers.
You got a syringe?
Sure, you got a pulse on him.
3 minutes later, they put a Band-Aid on the draw spot and then turn him over.
Lift his head up. Keep his airway open.
No response from Bronstein.
Where is CPR? Where is first aid? When they finally flip him over, he's lifeless. He's dead. He's cold. He's blue.
He at least deserved a chance to have CPR done. To be treated like a human, he was treated like trash.
Bronstein's family wants the officers prosecuted.
Punish them. Take them away. Take them out of them. Don't let them work anymore to hurt anybody like they did my son. And they're still working. I don't understand that.
We did try to reach CHP officials who are saying, quote, because there is pending litigation, the CHP cannot comment on this case at this time. I'm Christina Gonzalez, live in Altadena. Back to you guys in the studio.
Hard to watch. Christina, thank you.
I can't breathe, he gasps over and over again. That's 38-year-old Edward Bronstein of Burbank in handcuffs, being forcefully restrained by several CHP officers trying to take a court-ordered blood sample. This after a suspected DUI stop back in March of 2020. Bronstein initially resists, then agrees.
I'll do it willingly.
But he passed out, never regained consciousness, and died.
Wake him up.
I don't know what to say, but what happened, you know, it's just something I can't bear with yet, even now. I'm glad that we came to this point where they get prosecuted so they can hurt nobody else, go through what my son went through.
That was Bronstein's father reacting to the news that L.A. County District Attorney George Gascon, who played the CHP video at a news conference, has now charged one sergeant and six officers and a nurse from the CHP Altadena station with manslaughter. The CHP officers also charged with assault.
This officer had a legal duty to Mr. Bronstein. He was in their custody. We believe that they failed their duty, and their failure was criminally negligent, causing his death.
The coroner has ruled Bronstein's death was, quote, acute methamphetamine intoxication. The family and their attorneys acknowledge drugs and alcohol in his system, but say it's obvious the officers caused his death.
This is the George Floyd in our community. And the absence of oxygen means that the heart can't pump out the blood, and that's why he died.
The commissioner of the CHP responded, "Any death in custody is a tragedy that we take with the utmost seriousness. I recognize this case will now move through the court system, and I respect the judicial process." George Floyd killed in Minneapolis some 2 months after the Bronstein death. You heard attorney Luis Carrillo make reference to that. The CHP statement did not discuss the merits of the case at all. You heard him say he respects the judicial process. My understanding is that these officers will be allowed to surrender on their own. They won't be arrested, and it's unlikely they will ask for bail. They will no doubt be suspended now, but they've been on the job for the past 3 years.